Hi, I'm Evie Hoffman. In this video, I would like to share with you a few very effective somatic exercises that help to release tight muscles which externally rotate your hip. So if you have pain in the buttocks or the hips, those muscles might be the culprit. You can see if your these muscles are tight actually when you look at your feet and one foot, let's say you have a pain on one side and one foot is more turned out. That's one sign that these muscles pull and turn the leg out. So, well, when you look at the hip, the outer muscle is the gluteus maximus. It's kind of what we see, what is the shape. And that one also laterally rotates the hip. But underneath, there are various muscles, there are smaller muscles, and it's nearly like a spoke in the wheel. You know, there are various little muscles. They go from the hip, from different points, to the trochanter. And one of the muscles you might have heard of is called piriformis. And actually, when this muscle is tight, it will press on the sciatic nerve. So you'll have the same pain, the same nerve pain as in sciatica. So today I'll show you these exercises to release those muscles. And you know, we work with different angles because the way the muscles come in, they actually come from the fibers run more horizontal, more diagonal. So it's good to release these muscles in different positions. And before I show you the exercise, I again want to point out that please never do the exercises if it causes any pain, and just kind of when you do the exercises, don't strain, don't try hard, because the brain it's much easier to relax these muscles when there's not effort, and especially when there's pain, you can forget about it already. And anyway, would want you not to do it, then better talk with your doctor first then. So, and for these somatic exercises, we will work in a way that we first contract the tight muscle and then we release the muscle. So now I will just show you the exercises and then you can try them at home and see how that works for you. So you lie on the mat with the feet planted and the knees up, and we'll start here with the right side. So you lift the right leg so that the knee is just above the hip. All right? And the first action of the exercise, what we do is to move the knee towards the opposite hip. And you just do this without stretching, just as far as it is comfortable. And now, to give a little bit more feedback for our brain to release this muscle, we'll put the left hand on the knee and just very slightly press into the hand so that you feel the muscles in your hip contracting. You can even put your hand there for a little bit more feedback. And then you keep the resistance between the hand and the knee, and you slowly let the knee wander to the opposite him. And you do this with the breath. Breathe in when you push against your hand. And breathe out when you let the knee wander to the opposite hip. You do this about 3 to 4 times. Let this muscle on your hip really relax. And never push with the hand. It's not a stretch. It's kind of just now when you push with the knee against it to contract the muscle. But then when you go over, just kind of let the hand go with it for the ride. All right, and then you just go as far as you easily can go within your range of motion. And so each time, you can also imagine, so each time when you push against your hand, you contract and then you release and you go just as far as it easily goes. And then when it doesn't go any further, then you re-engage the muscle, you contract again. And then you release, and maybe the muscle releases a little more, and it will go a little bit further, but don't even be goal-oriented, just do it that way. So that's the first exercise, and then you repeat it on the other side also. So for the second exercise, again, we'll lift our legs so that the knees above the hip. But now, turn the lower leg so that the foot is just above the other knee. And now we're working more with these muscles which go in the diagonal direction. So you put, again, first you can just let the knee come towards the opposite shoulder a little bit, and then you put your hand on your knee. And you give with this hand some resistance, push against the hand to contract the muscles, and then ease off, breathe out, and let the knee slowly wander towards the opposite shoulder. So you do this again about 3 times, and so you push against your hand, and ease off, and let the knee come close to the opposite shoulder, just as far as these muscles allow, just as far as they release. And when it doesn't go any further, then you push against your hand again, and breathe out, and the knee goes to the opposite shoulder. And again, do this about 3-4 times. So do it one more time. Breathe in when you push and breathe out. And you release. All right. You put your leg down and you do it on the other side. And so even if the pain is only on one side, always do it on the other side. And it also will give this, you know, these muscles a little break, you know. So now the last one, just take your feet a little bit further apart so that they're more apart than hip width. And now we'll move the knee towards the other ankle towards the other foot to kind of drop the knee in. And we'll do this again, very gentle, without effort, no stretching. Just drop the knee in just as far as it naturally it wants to go. So for some people, when they're very tight, that might be just an inch or hardly at all. And then, so you drop the knee in, just as far as comfortable, and you bring it up. When you bring it up, you tighten these muscles. Now we don't have, you can a little put the hand here if you want, but you can do those without the hand. Just keep on dropping the knee in. And then you bring the knee up again. Just very simple. Do this also 3-4 times. And again, do this also with your breath. So breathe in when the knee comes up. And breathe out. When the knee comes down. So with all three exercises, the hips stay on the mat. So try this at home and let me know how it goes.